Hi guys, welcome you all to this session, transformation process of a input source file into an executable file. Each and every one of us tend to write a program either in C language, C++ language, Java language or Python language. How the input programming source file is converted into executable code file is all about the discussion in this video. In general, every user or every programmer tend to write a source program in English like text structure. We used to write program in English like structure. At time it will have some special symbols and numbers. Rest all it will be in the form of English. Now, how this programming language, source programming language which we write is translated into machine language in the form of zeros and one is the discussion. Which are all the system softwares involved in this translation process? What are all the stages and the components and the mathematics behind of each and every translation? And what are all the logic or the procedure behind of this high level language to machine level language translation? The way translation occurs is depending upon whether the programming language is compiled based language or compiler based language or interpreted language. There are two different way each and every language is compiled or translated into machine level language. There are two different softwares involved. One is compiler, another one is interpreter. In short, we will be discussing about the exact difference between compiler and an interpreter. There are four major components involved in the process of compilation: preprocessor, compiler, assembler, linker or loader, or linker and loader. Two different phases also we can treat, totally five different phases. When it comes to this phase compiler, again it is categorized into based on interpreted language or compiled language. Either we can substitute here interpreter or we can substitute here compiler. Preprocessor accepts source code. And source code is given to the preprocessor. It submits preprocessed code to the compiler or interpreter. Compiler or interpreter gives target assembly code. That target assembly code will be available in the assembly language. That assembly language program is given to assembler. Assembler will generate machine code in the form of zeros and ones. That code is said to be relocatable machine code. That relocatable machine code is given to linker. Linker combines different component and process phases of the entire program into a single file. All the library files, all the predefined files and macros all together, it combines and it gives one single file, that is linked file. That linked file is said to be executable machine code. That executable machine code is loaded to the designated memory location. It is called executable code memory. By the loader, the moment the program is loaded into the executable code memory, only then this memory, this code is submitted or this memory is accessed by the CPU for the program execution. This is the entire cycle of source code to machine code translation. Let us see how the C program is translated into machine code. User writes a program in C language. Compiler compiles a program. C is the language based on compiler. Compiles a program and translates it to assembly program. Assembler then translates the assembly program into machine code. Linker links all the parts of the program and predefined files, header files and library files together for execution in the form of machine code or executable machine code. The loader loads all of them into memory and then the program is executed. Preprocessor. Preprocessor always considered as part of the compiler. It deals with macro processing, augmentation, file inclusion, language extension. Either couple of the processing units will be dealt by the preprocessor or all of the components dealt by the preprocessor. Macros. Macros are shorthands for longer construct. In general, C language we used to have macros like this. We used to define hash define pi 3.14. Pi is a constant. The very first one is said to be constant macro creation. Second one is parameterized macro creation. Hash defined min A comma B. This is the macro, helps us comparing these two parameters and taking decision and returns the minimum among A and B. The code for this is using the conditional operator question mark. So this is how the macro is written in the C language. This macro helps for inline execution. So this macro is handled by macro component or macro preprocessor. File inclusion. Normally in C language, we used to do a file inclusion with hash define hash include construct, hash include stdio.h is the way we used to include the file. This is the part, or this is the portion preprocessed by the preprocessor. Augmentation. Older languages with modern flow of control and data structure facilities are augmented. Language extension can add new functionalities to extend the language by built-in macros, adding database query facilities to the language. Anything we want to extend the features of the existing languages, it is possible either with the support of augmentation or with the support of language extension. Language extension always useful for database query facilities, and augmentation is useful for data structuring facilities. Let us see the detailed way of how the preprocessing works with the C language piece of program. In C language, this is the demo we used to do. Hash include stdio.h. This is the commentary line, main function, printf hello. When this piece of program is given to preprocessor, what it does is includes the code of std.h file entirety into the programming code. The content of this file is brought to the user programming file. We may be naming the file first.c or hello world.c something, first.c. So stdio.h content is brought to the first.c file, then void main and printf hello. Preprocessor remove comments and include header files in source code, replace macro name with code. This is the role carried out by preprocessor mainly. Replace macro name with code. Hash define we have seen those kind of macro names are replaced by this code. Now, how that preprocessor code is sent to compiler? The moment preprocessor code is obtained by the preprocessor, it is submitted to the next module named as compiler. Compiler converts the entire piece of source code in terms of this assembly level language. This is called assembly level language. Subsequently, assembly level language program is given to the next component or the module named as assembler. Assembler converts it into finally object code or machine code or target code or target language or zeros and ones form. This is the role of assembler. With example, I am eliciting now. Linker does the different parts or pieces of the program combines into a single file. So that is a major role of linker. Pre-processing unit, macro unit, and subsequently user programming modules all together, different parts and components of the programs together combined and made it as a single file. That is a role of linker. Different parts of programs, let us say this is macro definition, this is our header file definition, this is our main program, all other libraries all put together, linked, and finally it gives one piece of information in the form of .exe file, that is final output of linker. Combined components, various parts of program, user defined modules, predefined modules, libraries, macros, all together, user defined main function, all the forms are combined together and it will be created. It has one exe file. That is the role of. Now let us move back to interpreter. Interpreter translates high level language into low level language as like compiler, but it considers one line at a time. One line is considered and it does various translation activities like source code, reading the source code at a time, one line at a time, creates a tokens. Shortly we will be discussing, while we discuss about phases of compiler, what is the meaning of token, and checks for semantic error, syntactic error, and generates intermediate code, executes the whole program. These are all the phases, but it does one line at a time. Let us watch one animated video for understanding the difference between compiler and interpreter. Compiler considers the whole program at a time and translates it into, reads the whole program at a time and translates it into machine code or target language. Whereas interpreter considers one line at a time and each and every line is translated from source language to target language. That is a major difference.
Run very quickly, efficient computers with their strange convoluted machine language. It's a bit like landing on another planet whose inhabitants speak an equally strange convoluted alien language. Getting a mechanic on planet Gobbledygook to repair your spaceship would present the same sort of problem that you have when you want to get a computer to do something. Everything you say has to be translated. And you have a choice between two different sorts of translator. One of them is called an interpreter, and the other is called a compiler. Let's suppose that you've previously written out your list of instructions for the repair of your spaceship. And suppose that you choose the interpreter to do the translating. He reads your first instruction, open lid of rocket engine, translates this into gobbledygook, and immediately passes it on to the mechanic, who executes the instruction. Then the interpreter reads your second instruction, remove spark plug, translates this into gobbledygook, and passes it on to the mechanic, who executes it. And so on and so forth. Now, notice how the interpreter works. He stays with you all the time, and he translates each of your instructions immediately, one by one. This is a rather slow process because the mechanic has to wait while each instruction is being translated. But on the other hand, it does give you a chance to correct your mistakes as you go along. If the mechanic removes the wrong spark plug, for instance, you'll see this happen right away, and you'll be able to change your instruction accordingly. Compare this with the way the second sort of translator, the compiler, goes about his work. He takes your complete list of instructions and without further ado translates the whole lot straight into gobbledygook. He then hands them back to you and goes away, leaving you all on your own. All this has taken some time, but from now on things will go very fast. You hand the complete list of gobbledygook to the mechanic and he executes them all in one go. Bang, bang, bang. There's no waiting about this time. But there's one disadvantage to this, of course. If there was a mistake in your instructions, it's too late now. This analogy comes very close to the way the interpreter and compiler translator programs actually work with computers. An interpreter runs slowly, starts right away, and lets you see how things are going. Whereas a compiler takes extra preparation time before your program can run, but then lets it run very quickly, efficiently. To help you remember the difference between an interpreter and a compiler, look at the words themselves. Inter means between. The interpreter is always between your program and the computer, and it translates line by line. To compile, on the other hand, means to pile together. A compiler piles together your entire program and translates the whole thing all at once. Which one you use on planet Gobbledygook is entirely up to you.
Hope so you would have understood the difference between interpreter and the compiler. Now assembler, linker, links various parts of programs and merges into together and creates one object file. That object file is given to loader. Loader loads into the designated memory location. So that memory location is accessed by the CPU, various register initialization and for initiate to the execution. The moment the program is brought to this designated memory location, only then it is possible to execute the program. And before loading to the memory, the size of the program is calculated by the loader. Instructions and data size both together. If it fits for the memory, one then it will be accommodated. If not, we used to see in executing lot of higher end programs, fatal error. Fatal error is one of the error. Whenever the memory inadequacy, memory insufficiency exists, then it generates fatal error. Otherwise, there is no other error will be given. Cross compiler, there is two different types of compilers available, source to source compiler, cross compiler. Cross compiler compiles a program A and is capable of generating executable to the platform B. For example, runs a platform A means Microsoft platform. Then it will be executed in the other platform like Linux also. It's called cross compiler, suitable for two different platforms. Source to source compiler, one of the source to source compiler is helpful for converting source code of one programming language to another programming language. For example, if you write a program in C language, using or with the support of source to source compiler, it is possible to convert it into C++ language. That is advantage of source to source compiler. Lot of modern languages, the recent languages has this feature. Now it's a kind of recap. Let us consider what is compiler, what is interpreter, which are all the languages comes under compiler. For a few examples we are going to look at. C and C++, both of the language, best suitable example for compiled languages. This compiled languages, source code is given to compiler. It generates object code or object file. That object code or object file is given to the linker. Linker uses all the runtime library files and combines together and making it as a single file. That single file, it gives us a executable file, that is the output of linker. So this is the role of compiler. Now let us move to interpreted programming language. Source code is given to interpreter, but only the difference is from the source language, it starts considering one line at a time. That one line is executed, translated up to the machine language. If there is a bug, if there is an error, it will not proceed further. If there is a bug, interpreter is a best language. We can rectify that bug or error in a line. Then we can proceed or resume with interpretation or the process of converting source language to the machine language. That is advantage of interpreter, but comparatively it is bit slower than the compiler. That is the only disadvantage. I hope you would have observed all the differences in the animated video Bits and Bytes episode 6, which I shown from the YouTube channel, so that you can remember and understand. Now there are language that is something different. One example is Java. Neither it fit into compiled language, nor it fit into interpreted language. This is illustrated here. What it does? This is the language, although it is interpreter, we used to call it as compiler, but it generates the form called bytecode. That bytecode is suitable for any platform like Linux, Windows, Mac OS. So the bytecode is subsequently given to the interpreter. Compiler generates source code is submitted to compiler. Compiler generates bytecode. Bytecode will be submitted to the interpreter. That interpreter is common to all the platform. That is why we used to say Java is common to all the platform. So Java compiler produces the file in the form of Java C and converts this source code into bytecode. Bytecode is a kind of average machine language. It's not exact machine language. It's a kind of average machine language. So this bytecode file extension will be available in the form of dot class. Then can be run on any operating system by using the Java interpreter, Java. So now the interpreter, normally in the case of Java, it is termed as virtual machine. This is termed as virtual machine. We need to remember this. Subsequently, this virtual machine will be submitted to different platforms. So virtual machine code is suitable for different platforms. It's a compromise between compiled and interpreted language. Virtual machine is in between, intermediate. Under ideal conditions, virtual machine runs faster, close to the compiler. There is no disadvantage of interpreter. That is the advantage of virtual machine. So in Java, the average machine language code is set as bytecode. At the end of this video, you are expected to know answer for the following question. What is compilation? What is interpreter? What is assembler? What is bytecode? What is linker? What is loader? What is object file? What is preprocessor? What is macro? What is virtual machine? What is cross compiler? What are tasks performed by preprocessor? What is source language? What is target language? What is system software? What is object file? System software is a software which helps for the programming component, compilation process, execution process. For example, compiler, system software is one of the system software, interpreter, assembler, linker, loader, preprocessor, macro processor. These all are example for system software. Whatever we discussed in this video, all those components are the best example for system software. Thank you for watching. Wish you all success. Keep watching with the subsequent videos.